on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown. Sean Locke, Bill Bailey, Henning Vane, Jessica Hines, Tom Allen, Susie Dent, and Rachel Riley. Now, welcome your hosts, Jim.
Welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. Did you know, for example, pandemonium is a term invented by John Milton in Paradise Lost to describe a nightmarish city in hell? Of course, today, we just say Blackpool. Proper nouns aren't allowed on Countdown, but fun fact, there's a town in France named Condom. I imagine it's full of dicks. And it was common practice for Native American cultures to use smoke signals to communicate. My nan tried to use smoke signals to communicate right until the moment she died. Turned out what she was trying to communicate was, I'm not dead, stop the cremation. Right, let's get started. OK, let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's Sean Locke. Sean's got a mind like a steel trap. Unfortunately, the steel trap in question has trapped an angry bear that doesn't understand letters or numbers. And joining Sean tonight is Henning Vane. German Henning is at an obvious disadvantage on Countdown because we speak English on this show, despite the very best efforts of Henning's grandfather.
It never gets boring or old.
Well, if you like that one, you're in luck.
Yeah.
Henning says if he has a bad gig, he feels OK, because not being funny is conforming to a national stereotype. Yeah, and because Germans love bombing. That was really creepy. Yeah, I scored the R. Up against them this evening, it's Bill Bailey. Bill Bailey is not only an award-winning comedian and writer, but he's also one of the last remaining habitats for the red squirrel. And Bill's teammate, Jessica Hines. Jessica's main hobby is crocheting. Crochet's great. Instead of buying people expensive gifts, you can make them something they'll hate for nothing. Now, Bill, you refer to yourself as a charm troll on Twitter. What's a charm troll?
A charm troll was a term that was used in a review I got in a gig in Oslo. It was all in Norwegian. It said, British comedian, charm troll. And it just means charming man, you know. But the actual literal translation is charm troll, which is... Look, I don't know if you see a picture. We've got a picture of one. There. That's actually a charm troll.
I can definitely see it.
Kind of a... It's more like Jimmy with his hair down.
He looks a bit like he's saying,
what do you want? I got no genitals. What do you want? At all, I got no ghoulies.
Jessica, it's your first time on Cats Does Countdown. What are you better at, the numbers or the letters?
I think marginally I'll probably be slightly less abysmal at the letters.
Were you good at maths?
I'm prepared. I'm managing your expectations.
Were you good at maths?
I was terrible at maths. I was awful at maths.
What about English?
I was not good at English. Oh. No, I was terrible at English.
Okay.
Oh, Sean.
What?
I've got a question for you. Where do you see yourself in 10 years' time? Sorry, are you laughing because you don't think he's going to make it?
In an urn is what you're thinking, isn't it?
I'm not going to be cremated.
Oh, where are you going to be?
I'm going to be stuffed.
Oh, yeah?
I've actually already discussed it with a taxidermist, and the final decision to be sorted out is which pose I'm going to be in.
Oh, yeah.
I'm either going to go for something like that, like sort of a shoe pose, like that,
no way.
Or like that, or just go for the traditional...
Oh, that takes up a lot of space, doesn't it?
Mm.
Yeah, but it's also quite useful. You put coats on it.
Well, I think I obviously I'd be the entrance to a grand museum of all my work.
Diorama.
Yeah, everything I've done will be in there. And as you walk in, you'll meet me going, shoo. No, 10 years' time, knowing my luck, I'll end up married to, like, Gwyneth Paltrow. You know, oh. I'll be with Gwyneth and I'll be smuggling pepperamis past her.
Yeah, I'm just busy. Oh, for fuck, it's a pork pie. Get over it.
Henning, I know you've been living in this country for a long time now, but I can detect a tiny bit of your German accent. What bits of the English accent have you picked up?
Well, what can I say, Jimmy, me old mucker? It's just... I can always tell when I'm being insulted. So that's probably the biggest step forward. Like, I remember when I started out doing stand-up and then the compere would come on after and go, give Henning another round of applause, he's doing it in his second language. I always took that as a face value compliment.
Yeah. Mm.
But now I understand it's a British way of saying, oh, I couldn't understand a bloody word.
OK, Sean, have you got a mascot this evening?
No, I haven't got a mascot, Jimmy. But I've seen a gap in the market.
Right.
I don't know if you noticed that plugins are seem very popular these days. Mm. Some kind of smell to drift through your house, cover all the other smells. And I encountered one the other day and I thought, it doesn't smell like a summer meadow to me. Smells more like a sort of strippers run through your house. And I thought, why isn't there a wider range of plugins? Maybe a more sort of masculine range of plugins. Smells that you would say were more masculine, the appreciated smells. And I've come up with a range of plugins. This is my pasty plugin. yeah. And that's called Ginster's Meadow. And that is so nice. You plug that in, and that is just a love. You smell that. Oh, get a whiff of that. It's lovely, yeah, isn't it? And that smells so nice, you wouldn't want to leave the house. That's the main problem. You just want to stay in there going, hmm. There's that one. And there's this one here. That's a combination of 3-in-1 oil, creosote, and Swarfiga. It's called Dad's Shed. And this one is one of my favourites. Plug that in, you've got a lovely smell of Airfix glue. And all I'll say is don't put this in the kids' bedroom because technically it is just glue sniffing. So then I thought, what I love the smell of cheese. So what about a lovely cheese plug-in? So we've got Stilton there, look at that, isn't that? Oh, ooh, smells like Russell Brand's bedroom. This is Edam.
Can you just use the cheese?
They're too big to all plug in.
Are you saying I would need to make a decision as to which cheese I wanted to smell in the house?
No, because I wanted to give an all-over cheese shop aroma. Oh, for Christ's sake! That's...
Henning, do you have a mascot?
Yeah, well, I'm not overly sentimental, but yeah, I've got.
What is it, Henning?
That's the closest you'll ever get to it. Yeah, back home, everyone's got one.
How many have you got again?
Of them, three, and one of the predecessors, so four.
Four World Cups, they've won. Mm.
Four World Cups?
Yeah.
How many wars? Philip, you got a mascot?
Yes, I have. It's a an Alp horn, and normally, as you can imagine, these things are quite long. But right. This is my own one I've had specially made. This is a telescopic carbon fibre flick horn. I'll demonstrate how you extend the horn. You might just want to watch yourself there,
right,
Jimmy.
Yeah, go on.
You might need a bit of a woo.
Not the first time that's happened to me before. Oh.
Now, at this point, you could try and play it, Jimmy. Well, but,
how does one play
just
such
purse
a thing?
Purse your lips. Oh, that's pretty good. Yeah.
I have to say,
that is very impressive.
I have to say, I think you've blown Bill's horn before. Yeah.
So I'll just spin it round like that. Yep. Hang on. All right.
Oh, Jesus!
Jesus!
Now, here we go. And the thing is, these are used... they were used in olden times to communicate across vast distances in the Alps. And sometimes they were used to tell people what time it was. And here's an example. And that way, they'd know it's 7 o'clock. So, the Alpine horn, there you are.
And I've already written you a song.
Have you?
Yeah.
Go on.
The song about Switzerland. Say,
yes.
Yeah? Okay, then.
All right, I'll jam along with you.
Yeah.
Well, this is a treat, ladies and gentlemen. This is.
The countryside is nice and old. The mountains full of stolen gold.
Nazi gold. Right.
Jessica, have you got a mascot?
I have. I've got a little doll that comes from one of my favourite films that has 18 different lines from the film Napoleon Dynamite. Let me... Maybe if I just get the...
Pedro, just listen to your heart. That's what I do.
He said, Pedro, just listen to your heart. That's what I do.
Maybe I will. Gosh!
It's not the one of the most quotable films, is it?
OK, over in Dictionary Corner, it's Tom Allen.
Oh. Thank you.
Welcome to Dictionary Corner, Tom. The three rules for Dictionary Corner are, 1, wait until the round ends before making any suggestions. 2, proper nouns, brands and place names don't count. And 3, don't fuck with Susie Dent.
OK.
Tom, it's your first time on the show. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
I suppose I'd say I've been recently going to the gym, been working out, trying to get big arms, trying to turn my arms into legs. I'm also very adept with a hand whisk. And what else can I tell you? Oh, and I'm gay. Well, I say I'm gay. I hardly find the time. But...
It's a big commitment.
It's a big commitment, and I do think it's very important to talk about gay issues. You know, a lot of people come up to me and say, you know, Tom, I didn't know what homophobia was until I met you.
Well, it's fabulous to have you here. I'm with Tom, of course. Susie Dent. Susie, during your tireless work as a lexicographer, have you ever come across any fun, bad language?
Oh, loads. Yeah, I think I recommended to Bill this great dictionary called The Classical Dictionary of the Vulgar Tongue by Francis Gross. And there are lots of words in there that sound really rude, but they're actually not. Like, buttercan tongue is actually a scolding wife. and a bum brusher was a schoolmaster.
Well, some of them are, but you can't. OK, and in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel Riley's a mathematician who appeared on Strictly Come Dancing, where she proved beyond any doubt that she is a mathematician. Rachel, you're on telly all the time. You must get recognised a lot, but do you ever get mistaken for anyone else?
My producer thinks I look like Michael Heseltine. I think only old people know the Michael Heseltine reference. I had to Google a picture. There we go.
Oh, my God, is that your dad? That's really making me feel weird about my crush on Michael Heseltine. OK, tonight, the prize the teams will be competing for is this, the Countdown One-Man Band. Is there anything he won't do? OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. Bill and Jessica, your turn to pick the letters.
You go first.
Consonant, please.
Good choice. Start with M.
Consonant.
P.
Vowel, please.
O.
P.
pom.
Okay.
Mop.
Another vowel, please.
A.
Poma.
Consonant, please.
S.
Spammo. Spammo.
Vowel.
Do you realise you're just giving these away?
I.
Consonant. Consonant, please.
N.
Another consonant, please.
Why?
Another consonant, please.
And the last one, another M.
OK, and your time starts now. Done one to scale as well. Sean, how many you got?
Five.
Henning?
I'll say six.
Six?
Yeah.
OK. Bill?
I've got a dodgy six or a five.
What are you going to go for?
Well, I'm going to go for the dodgy six, obviously.
Excellent news. OK, Jessica, what have you got?
Four.
A four-letter word.
I've got a four-letter word, yeah.
OK, well, no, let's hear it.
Soap. Cute.
That was, I mean, that was the most patronising... She's an award-winning writer. That's disgraceful. Soap.
Skip back to soapy.
Yeah, that's what I've got. Soapy.
You've got soapy.
Yeah. Or moans.
Moans feels more you.
Moans. I'm quite soapy.
Oh, get out of my mind. Bill, what's your six?
I've got spammy.
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 Spammy a word. Like, Susie is...
It's, you know, this is spam and this is spammy. So
and you can check the same word for me.
Oh, OK. Yeah.
And is it one M or two M? That was my question.
It's probably two M's if it was in the dictionary, but it's not, I'm afraid.
OK. 5 points to Sean. At Tom. Susie, could they have done any better?
Susie came up with Mopanis. Mm. Which I'm sure a lot of people here will know.
They're trees with leaves that fold up in the heat.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Henning are in the lead with 5 points. On to our first numbers round. OK, Sean and Henning, your turn to pick the numbers.
OK, Henning, let me show you how it's done. Two from the top, four from somewhere else.
Thank you, Sean. The four little ones are one, six, five, and two, and the big ones, 25 and 50.
Oh, I'm feeling good about this.
And the target, 953.
OK, and your time starts doable. Now. So the target was 953. Jessica, did you get it?
No, I didn't get it. No, I didn't get it.
But you got very close, though, I would imagine. How close
yes,
did you get?
Yes, oh, I got 29.
You got 29?
I got as far.
Go on, tell me, just be honest, come on. What did you get?
No, actually...
There's no wrong answers on this show.
Actually, I didn't get... I got 35.
Could you talk us through how you got the 35? How did you get?
I multiplied 6 by 5. And
then... Sorry, what did you get again with 6 times 5?
35.
It's 30, isn't it?
Is it 30? 30. Had I had a bit more time, I think I might have got a bit further.
Yeah, no, I think if you'd had time to go back and resit your GCSE.
Anyway, sorry, Bill.
So, Bill, did you get any closer than 35?
900. I got 900.
Got 900.
Yeah, yes. OK, Sean?
900.
Got 900 as well. Henning?
974.
Ooh.
OK. So, no-one got close enough to get any points. Could it be done?
Yeah, you could have done this one. If you say 25 minus 6 is 19, times by 50 is 950.
Oh,
and now
that's what I was.
That's 50 times the table. And that's,
very good, very good.
To be honest with you, I would love to say it's nerves or something, but I wouldn't have thought of that at home either.
No.
Well, you wouldn't be watching, would you?
Oh, not that Sean Locke again. What's on Eurosports? Oh, darts, yay!
OK, so Sean and Henning have 5, Bill and Jessica have no points. Mm.
Sorry, Bill.
OK, time to go across to Dictionary Corner. Tom, what have you got for us?
Hello, Jimmy. Erotic literature. Now, erotic literature is popular with everyone. It appeals to our basest desires. And it's cheaper than buying someone dinner. And with all, as with all literature, it's sometimes nicer to read it out loud. Now, if you're reading this at a church group or perhaps on Radio 4, you might find that it's nicer to replace the rude words with other words to make it politer. In this example, from 50 Shades of Grey, I have replaced the rude words with popular stations on the recently privatised East Coast mainline. This is your punishment. So close and yet so far. Is this nice? He breathes in my Stevenage. I whimper, exhausted, pulling against my Edinburgh Waverley. I'm helpless, lost in an erotic Grantham. Retford, I beg. And he finally takes Durham on me. How shall I York you, Anastasia? Oh, my body starts to Dunbar. Please, what do you want? Doncaster, now! I cry. Shall I York you this way, or Wakefield Westgate? That's an endless choice, he breathes against my lips. He kneels up between my Hartford loop line. Very slowly, he pulls my Finsbury Park off. Staring down at me, his eyes gleaming. How nice is this, he says. He raises his eyebrows as his hand moves up and down his impressive Newark Northgate. He stares down at me for a moment, measuring my need, then he grabs me suddenly and flips me London King's Cross. It takes me by surprise, and because my hands are tied, I have to support myself on my Berwick-upon-Tweed. And from his impressive Peterborough, I instantly Darlington again and again.
Mm. Tom Allen, everyone. And here's your teaser. The words are arse bike. The clue is you'll get nice buns. That's arse bike. You'll get nice buns. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were arse bike. The clue was you'll get nice buns. It was, of course, bakeries. Now, Bill, your current show is about the gap between how we imagine our lives to be and how they really are. Can you give us an example?
Yes, well, I mean, I'll give you an example. Yeah, I went to get a massage and thinking that this would be a good thing, you know, relaxing and enjoyable, you know. And I got undressed, put the robe on, put the little hairnet thing on like that, and I waited for the masseuse to come back in. And she opened the door, and as she opened the door, I'm not exaggerating, her expression was this. She opened the door, she went... Because it wasn't a hairnet, it was a disposable underpants. So she said, you have to, you know... So I went, what? Not now! And then, so she went out the room and I put the pants on, and then, I just for a laugh, I put another pair on my head. And so she came in, I went, like that, and she went, no! And I went, don't worry, ta-da, like that. And then she went, okay, so that was... Disaster.
Yeah, not as relaxing as you would want. So, Sean and Henning are in the lead. Time to mix things up a bit. They've been playing in teams so far, but this game is just for Sean and Bill. So, Sean, your turn to choose the letters.
OK, can I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thanks, Sean. H.
H. Yes. And another consonant, please.
Z.
And another consonant, please.
Z.
R.
And another consonant, please.
N.
And another consonant, please.
Oh.
Oh, for God's sake.
And then a vowel, please.
E.
And another vowel.
O.
And another vowel.
E.
And I have to go for another vowel.
And the last one. I.
OK, and your time starts now. This night it's going to be absolutely fine. We're going to give him a nice hot bath with some carrots and some onions, aren't we? What have you got, Sean?
Seven.
Bill?
Five.
Five. Well, what's the five?
Noise.
Noise. And what's your seven, Sean?
Well, I'm not sure of it, but I'll try it. Reshine.
Ooh. Hello. No, it's not there.
Ah.
Sorry.
So, 5 points to Bill. Tom, Susie, could they have done any better?
Well, heroines for lots of heroin.
Heroises as well. If you idolise somebody, you heroise them. That's their
That doesn't sound like a real word.
I know.
Where does that come from? Who's allowed that in the dictionary? What prick let that go in the dictionary? It's horrible. Heroises. Idolises. Heroises.
You're breaking the third rule of Countdown.
What's that?
Yeah.
You're fucking with Susie Dent.
Yeah.
I'm not. OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Henny have 5 points, Bill and Jessica have 5 points. It's neck and neck. Let's not get overexcited. It is neck and neck in a very low-scoring game. Right now, time for Henning and Jessica to go head-to-head. Jessica, your turn to choose the numbers.
Can I have three from the top, please?
Yeah.
And then I'm going to have three from the bottom. That's it. Deal with it.
Sensible,
that's
yeah.
That's good, right?
Yeah. That's how you do it.
Three, two, seven, and the big one's 100, 25 and 75.
That's all manageable.
And the target, 568.
OK, and your time starts now.
Yeah, give or take. Nothing's easy in this game.
Jessica, did you get it?
No, I didn't, but I did get 550.
550? Well, that's bloody close. That's only 8 points away from
getting
a point.
Yeah.
So, Henning, did you get it?
I have got here 568.
Wow. Well done, Henning.
I mean, yes, would have sufficed, but OK. You've really built tension there. Henning, how did you do it? Talk us through it.
2 + 3 = 5, times 100 is 500.
Yep.
Then add another 75 and deduct a 7.
Perfect. 568.
Oh, yeah.
10 points to Henning. OK, time to go across once again to Dictionary Corner. What have you got for us this time, Tom?
Well, Jimmy, one of the ways I like to make my friends think I'm better than them is by telling them about my recent trip to Japan. Have you ever been?
No.
Exactly. Whilst I was there, I found this book called English Adult Conversation Collection, a bizarrely named Japanese-to-English phrasebook. And I've been practicing these wonderful and eminently useful Japanese phrases. For example, Oshiri no katachi ga kako yo. Gosh, what a good-looking hip you got there. And then another, Sube sube shite oishituna hada dane. Your skin looks so smooth and tasty to me. Or a personal favourite, which is Zenshin ga urakita kajitsu no yuda. Your body is just like matured fruits. Useful advice there in case you ever go to Japan, which, of course, I doubt any of you ever will.
I speak a bit of Japanese. I went to see when I was in Tokyo. I went to see a Japanese Beatles tribute act. One of the most glorious things I've ever seen, because they didn't speak any English, but they spoke. They said arigato gozaimashita, hai, ano ne, so desu ka. I wanted to hold your hand, you. And then they would sing, I wanted to hold your hand. It was glorious, and made more glorious by the fact the bloke playing John Lennon was the spit of Yoko Ono.
The scores at the moment, Sean and Henning are on 15, Bill and Jessica are on 5, and here is your teaser. The words are gimp hunt, the clue is, can cause bruising. That's gimp hunt, can cause bruising. See you after the break.
Ooh.
Welcome back. The answer to the teaser. The words were gimp hunt, the clue was, can cause bruising. It was, of course, thumping. How's the Alpine horn, Bill?
Well, it's still here. If you want me to extenderize it again.
Oh, yeah.
Hold on a sec. I just have to hang on.
would be a weird way to. Why do you wear a patch over one eye? Well, funny story.
You know those telescopic Alpine horns?
Yeah. Okay. Well, what about the theme tune then? Well, I probably can't play all of it.
I could try and yodel it.
You yodel the first bit, and I'll do the last bit. All right, ready?
You've literally never listened to it.
It doesn't go. What show have you been watching?
The end.
Oh, at the end it goes. Yeah, well, what about right. Da, 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 da,
okay, da, da, okay,
that
okay,
bit? Yeah,
okay.
That, the one that we know. I'll do it.
No, I was just going to shake your hand.
Oh,
you're right. Any work, Mr.
Bailey. Cheers, thanks very much, John. Always love, always a pleasure.
I think we can all agree.
One of them. Okay, on with the game.
Bill and Jessica, of course, have to choose the letters. Bill, Jessica, choose the letters.
I have a continent, please.
Continent. Jessica, continent. Pick a letter.
You choose one.
Nice when you find something you're good at. Bill, do you have any other extendable wind instruments?
OK, we've got 3 letters picked out so far.
OK, consonant, please.
C.
And another consonant, please.
D.
And a vowel, please.
A.
And another consonant.
L.
And another consonant, please.
S.
And another vowel.
And the last one.
Thank
E.
You.
OK, and your time starts now. So, Bill, how many letters?
7.
7?
Yeah, 7.
Jessica, what do you got?
Yeah.
Maybe an 8.
Maybe an 8.
Maybe an 8. This is huge. OK, Henning.
I have got... Now, the spelling might let me down, but I have got a 7, I believe.
Yeah, the spelling is sort of the key thing in this game.
It's absolutely, it is, yeah. But I think it's a 7.
OK, and Sean?
I've only got a 6.
Well, let's hear your 6. What you got?
Clears.
Bill?
Cradles.
Oh, very good.
Cradles. Mm. Henning, what you
Same.
Got?
Same, cradles.
Jessica, let's hear your 8.
Scalders. People who scold the scalders.
Scalders?
There's only one S.
Oh, is there?
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
OK. So, 7 points to both teams. Tom, Susie, could they have done any better?
Well, of course, they could have had carloads.
Carloads.
It means how much is in a car.
All right, so at the end of that, Sean and Henning are in the lead with 22 points. On to another numbers round. OK, Sean, Henning, your pick of the numbers. Henning, what are you going to go for?
3 and 3, please.
3 big ones and 3 little ones. And this numbers game is 10, 9, 8 and... 175 and 25, and the target 547.
Okay, your time starts now. So the target was 547. The fact that Rachel has a clipboard out suggests that this is not doable. Henning, did you get it?
550.
Sean?
No.
Bill?
Yeah, I got 549.
Jessica?
I didn't get it. There. That's how close I got there.
You wrote the numbers down?
Yes, I did.
Bill?
I got 550 by times 10 plus 9... 19 times 25 is 475,
yep,
plus right. 75, 550.
550, yeah, 3 away. Well done.
I don't be somebody who's like a real stickler for the rules. You declared a different number.
Yeah, no, I changed mine.
549,
yeah. That's one of the. Oh, really? Oh, it's so annoying.
Oh. But it doesn't matter, we have got 548, so we're fine.
Yeah, but you declared 550.
But I better myself for 548.
You can't
but 550
that.
Was 75 times 9 minus 100 minus 25.
Yeah, 550. Well done.
And now what I should have done is deduct another 10 and then add 8.
Yeah, well done. To get one away.
Okay, so you get the points there, Henning, for 550. Rachel, could it be done?
Yeah, I think it was a hard one. You could have said 75 plus 9 is 84, times by 8 is 672, and then take away the 100 and the 25.
Obviously,
five,
yeah.
5, 4, 7. Yeah.
To go across now to Victory Corner one last time. What have you got for us, Tom?
Well, Jimmy, I really like watching movies and films, which are the same thing. Sometimes, when I can't get to the cinema, I like to take the script and, with a friend, read the dialogue out loud. Susie's going to help me on this. And this is one of my favourites. It's an adaptation of Boys in the Hood. Why every time you talk about a female, you say bitch or whore or hoochie?
Because that's what you are.
Fuck you.
Hey.
Put the gun away. Can't we have one night where nobody gets shot?
Shut up, bitch.
Bitch, I'm gonna fuck you up.
Come on, let's go.
I'm getting the fuck out of LA. You can't go nowhere without it getting all shot up and shit.
Bitch.
Shit fuck. And that's just something you can do at home if you can't get to the cinema, or perhaps you have a bedbound relative.
The scores at the moment, Sean and Henning have 29, Bill and Jessica have 12. Here's your final teaser. The words are solo, parp. The clue is, put your finger in my ring. That solo part, put your finger in my ring. See you after the break. The answer to the teaser, the words were solo part. The clue was, put your finger in my ring. It was, of course, proposal. OK, time for our final letters game. Sean and Henning, your turn to choose.
Have a vowel, please.
A.
Another vowel.
E.
Vowel.
I.
Consonant, please.
K.
Consonant.
S.
Consonant.
F.
Consonant.
T.
Consonant.
G.
A vowel.
Good input, Henry.
OK, and your time starts now. Henning, what have you got?
Not enough. well, five.
Five, OK. Sean, what have you got?
Five.
Bill?
Ich habe fünf.
Sorry, just...
Yeah. Sehr gut, sehr gut. Ja? Danke. Wo hast du Deutsch gelernt?
Ja, ich habe ein bisschen in Schule gelernt.
Und du sprichst das aber sehr gut.
Ja, danke.
Genauso wie, ich weiß nicht, besser dein Japanisch oder dein Deutsch?
Ja, ich kann auf diese Weise eine billige Lache bekommen.
Das ist ja alles, was zählt hier.
I don't know what they're talking about, but I presume living space. Jessica, what have you got?
Five.
Speak.
Speak's there. Bill, what have you got?
Five. Pages.
Pages.
Oh, clever. Very good.
Or spike.
That was a very good.
What have you got, Sean?
Gapes.
Henning, what have you got?
Spike.
Okay. Yeah. Well, they're all there. Lots of fives. 5 points for both teams. Tom, Susie, could they have done any better?
Well, they could have done, of course. Everybody can. Susie said Sifaka,
which I love the sound of this, a large gregarious lemur which leaps from tree to tree in an upright position.
Sifaka.
OK, so Sean and Henning have 34, Bill and Jessica have 17. Time for today's countdown conundrum. The time starts now.
What are we trying to achieve?
Find the word.
Oh.
What are we trying to achieve? Get it?
No. It's nice to press the button. Yeah. To create that sense of expectation.
Tit shower. Tit shower.
You're saying tit shower.
It's tow heights. Tow heights.
Jessica is still soldiering on here.
Well, I've got
shower tit.
Well, I got seven. I did get what seven.
What did you get?
Withers.
Well, it's better than anyone else did.
Thank you. Thank you.
I think you should get points for that.
Yes.
Withers, I think.
Rules, Jimmy.
Seven.
I hate them. I'm with you. I'd love nothing better than you.
Shit tower. Tower shit.
Shit tower. I'm in the shit tower.
I've got the rules here. That's
a German expression means I'm in really bad trouble. I'm in the shit tower today.
Well, let's have a look and see what it should have been. None of you were worthy.
Worthiest.
OK, so the final scores are Bill and Jessica have 17, Sean and Henning are our winners with 34.
They're going to win.
Thanks to all our panelists, our wonderful studio audience.
Those high school days are the best years of your life, right? Follow the triumphs and tribulations of the students in brand new Educating Cardiff, Tuesday at 9. Next tonight, let the lols roll on as Jack Whitehall crashes the last leg party.